kick here anyway. And the Dolphins are going to recover. I know they're down, but starting the third quarter there with the onside kick, what'd you think?
Well, I think that they're looking at it as we may not have as many possessions in this game as we want. There may be that sense and that feel that they've got to go ahead and make something happen, steal possession, try and steal some points, and get themselves right back in a position to try and win the game.
He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And finally down at the 32-yard line.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just
going
to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
2 yards the loss, second and 12. Now Tua. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
When you run into slant, timing is everything, and against that man coverage, there is no space available, and incompletion as a result.
Here's Tua. Smith catches left side. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number three. 3 quarters in the books. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Running for it. Here's Lynch. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They'll run with Marshawn Lynch. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Tua sets up to pass it. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And, oh, it's incomplete. Oh, that would have been 6 points, but somehow he couldn't rein it in.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Tua going to throw. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit, because it nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
The Hall of Famer's kick is good, and that'll make this a 7-point game. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Play action. It's Wilson. Out to his left. And I think the ball's out. And this is picked up by the Dolphins.
Now, let's be frank. You hate the fumble at the end of the play. But prior to that, I liked a lot of what was going on. Tucks it down, takes off, picks up good yardage. But in that portion of the field, that close to the sideline.
Step out.
Yeah, either get down or get out of bounds. Take care of the ball.
Yeah, he had the yards, but then the mistake. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. Again, they'll pound it with Lynch. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa sliding out of the pocket. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. That is an absolute backbreaker. That was a design passing play, wasn't a draw. You think you got him stopped, good coverage downfield, and he's able to pick up the first with his legs. Defensively, that kicks into your psyche and hurts a little bit, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and here's the thing. Anytime you give up a first down, it hurts you psychologically, but it hurts more when they get it this way, because you've covered everything. He didn't have any place to throw the football. He takes off running and picks it up anyway, and now you have to stay on the field for an extra set of downs.
And really could have used that stop trailing here in the fourth. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Lynch, and they'll get him down right about the 20. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down. The gun they give to Ingram. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Marshawn Lynch taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead.
You're a smart cheater. Get your story easy to say that
they
screen.
Are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And the lead now up to 14. So the extra point good, and the roughing call going to move the ball out to the 50 for the kickoff.
And I think this is a good chance to pin them deep if you can land the kickoff inside the 5-yard line or so. Gain some field position for your defense.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. On first down, Wilson. The Dolphins get there this time and they bring him down. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Meanwhile, Wilson's throw caught by his receiver, Hill. Wilson now to throw on third down. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down. And it's incomplete. They can...
for the show. Flat rich kid got all of the clothes. People like you get all of the nose. I stay making wins, I stay with the pros. Just made a stack, I'm watching it grow. Up in the sky, everybody so low. I keep me like foe, he sleep on the floor. He don't got no money, I show him the dough. Oh no, kid can't never with a bozo. Name in his mouth like froyo. With a rich baddie, looking for the bros. If he really with it, make him cash off the code, bro. Any, many, miney, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, miney, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit.
We are set, ready to rock for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup, and these guys on your screen, ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game, and speaking of the game, let's get right to it.
Another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. When the kick off the bomb, run it back.
Home.
Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pack. Familiar with the scrubber, look, I'm coming up from scratch.
Nothing.
Huddle with my pain, then I turned it to some racks.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gon' tackle your little man.
Get them.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go.
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me some.
That's another set, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. Pop out, treat this block like an end zone.
What?
Score. Check it. Benji calling money my ringtone.
100.
Or blue. Put her in a friend zone. She turned on more.
Ooh.
Take one for the team. I do that for my boy.
Bread. Game.
Time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man, I bet we win it. Go hard or go home, it's survival of the fittest.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do. That's another set, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move. It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
For permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I be and check out how I tend to mine.
I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time, but let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, and that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory till the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not walk with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace for peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams of my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, swing the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
Brandon Gaughan, Charles Davis, ready for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players in today's game, and you're a big player in today's game as well. Let's get the party started. Saint and Viking Morton Anderson to get this one started, and we are underway from Santa Clara, and he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Excellent job pushing through tacklers that time to pick up six. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. On the handoff, Lynch. Shedding the tackler, and it gives him some room. And some room to maneuver. 20, 10, 5, and all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Marshawn Lynch. 69 yards, and the Dolphins on just two plays have taken the lead. Morton Anderson now for the extra point. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins. Following the touchdown, here's Anderson to kick it away. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door. A little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Allen. Flushed out right. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And this is caught inside the five. They've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass.
Yeah.
And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. From back at the 4, here's second and goal. Here's Allen. Touchdown 49ers! Debo Samuel from 30 yards out. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Well, go ahead and strap in, partner. Less than 2 minutes in, had the score on the one side. A quick answer, though, to get the equalizer.
Sometimes you get that sense of urgency that ratchets up, right? When you give up an early touchdown like that, you just know, you're like, okay, how do we go back and equalize things? Can we get it done fast? And they absolutely did. Essentially, we're back to even, aren't we?
Following the touchdown, here's Anderson to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble of bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
89 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Now they'll throw with Tagovailoa. Pass complete to DK Metcalf. They get 6. That'll leave him with 3rd and 4. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
Back to the ground, Lynch. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. On the ground, it's Lynch. Space to run past the 20. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Marshawn Lynch with his 2nd touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Dolphins are going to jump back in front. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that makes this a 14-8 ball game. Following the touchdown, here's Anderson to kick it away. San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan.
And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. Sam Hubbard making his presence felt in the backfield. I thought there at the end he may have had a chance to release that, but that pocket closed a little too quickly and down he went.
Yeah, he was certainly trying to do everything he could to extend the life of the play, probably counting in his head, 1, 2, and then he ran out of time.
Now a throw here to his running back, and he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to 3rd down. Allen looks to throw on 3rd and 1. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by the 13-time Pro Bowler Ray Lewis. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Let's go, baby. Let's
go, baby. It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Now to try to add the extra point, the lefty Anderson. He knocks it through, and he extends the lead to 21-8. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Here comes Johnson on the return. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as these guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown this off. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Miles Jack. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. And that now two interceptions thrown in the second quarter.
And you know, a lot of people look at these guys and they think to themselves that maybe, possibly, they're still thinking about the first one. And they probably are. I think in this case, he's just trying to atone for the first interception. Tried a little bit too hard, maybe forced it a bit, and instead created a second one.
Second down, it's Lynch, and just a couple yards there down to the 17. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
So they've been unable to capitalize on the great field position as of yet. Here's 3rd and 9. They'll set up a throw, looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Smith. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a 1st and goal.
The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. They'll run. Here's Burton, the fullback. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line.
That's someone who's pretty happy right there. That's the defense coordinator. Body after body getting to him before he can get started.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action.
Time go by in an hour. to a place. Spend a little money, don't care how it's made. Drop top, cool, catch sun rays. Started off with attic, gotta get it one day. Doing 200 on the runway. Got a bad chick and she ripping the runway. It's Super Bowl Sunday. Rip out my heart, you're a demon. I get the money for real no reason. Why everybody come through unpolitely? I ride around in exotic. Wake me up cause I gotta be dreaming. If only my dogs could see this. I never had no money.
Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. Saint and Viking Morton Anderson to get this one started, and we are underway from Santa Clara. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. Signal for a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. The 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. A run here with Lynch. He'll be tackled shy of the 35. The power move there couldn't buy him much space. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down. Set up to throw. They go screen. This is Ingram. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. So Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath. Maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball. But you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Looking to throw. Incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. Could not hang on. It's third down. To throw. Throw left side complete. That's Smith. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first.
And let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him, you're not going to be able to disguise him, because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up front on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
They'll run for it. Lynch, and try to push his way forward, but I think he's going to be short, and he is short. He needed two. He only got one. And this crowd into it early. Their guys stand tall on the opening drive of the football. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. This is the former Dolphin, Reggie Bush. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
From the 38, Lance, flush to his right. And he fires one that's intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick, and the Dolphins are going to get it back here just shy of the 20. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. On the give, this is Lynch. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two. Score after one on EA Sports. The 49ers have an extra defensive back on the field, a nickel set for third down. Back to throw. And the Niners get there and bring him down. Nick Bosa from out on the edge, who worked his way in for the sack. He was still looking through his progressions and going through his receiver options, and while he was doing that, the defense got to him quickly in the pocket.
And it was a great example of zone coverage, well executed, well coordinated. All the receivers were covered, and he couldn't evade the rush back in the pocket.
Tagovailoa going for it on fourth down. Returning right back to Lockett. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. On second down now, it's Lynch. And he'll have a Dolphins first down as good running gets him to about the 44.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
And he's got this one across midfield into 49er territory. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Second down, it's Lynch, and he'll get this down only to about the 46. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
41 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. This is Ingram on 1st and 10. And he'll get inside the 40 to maybe the 38-yard line. On 2nd down, Ingram again. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time.
Well, to me, that's taking a big gamble defensively because that alignment, you see, that's normally something you see down near the goal line, because now if they decide to go play action, something should be open there, and I think open big.
So maybe that's something that gets filed away for later.
I think without a doubt, you write it down, and if you see that look at a later date, go ahead and take your shot.
This one complete to Ingram. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. The Dolphins going to take their 2nd timeout, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. It's a 47-yard field goal try from here, but instead they're going to opt to go for it on 4th down. They'll try and run for it. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Thought they might throw the football with a little chunk that they had remaining on 4th down, but they ran it, they got it.
And the reason they were able to get it done, he ran that play with conviction, didn't he? Understood he would get a little bit of help from his friends up front, but it was really on him to go ahead and make the power move and get it done, and that he did.
The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. Back to the ground, this time with Ingram. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And able to get this down inside the 15 to either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. Anderson's kick is good. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. So a good kick there. They put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the throw.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Well, the white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. He'll take the knee, and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. Is seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And maybe time for this offense to really hit the reset button. They were shut out in the first half, but still, they're right in this game.
They certainly are. What I like about it is that you actually continue to play. You know, you just find a way to make a few plays yourself, and you noted it. Right there on the border in this game, they're not that far off. Just got to find a play or two, and they could be very happy at that point.
To the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. The clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Give him a couple on the run there. It'll be second and 13.
Well, obviously, they would have at least liked to have gotten back to the original line of scrimmage. Instead, now, they're dealing with second and long.
I thought they would have passed it after the penalty. Probably wish they would have now. On second down now, it's Craig. It looks like a pickup of 6. That leaves him with 7 yards to go on third down.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. On third down, and he's going to have a Niners first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
So that's what that elbow in my ribs was all about. You thought they were going to throw the ball as well.
Absolutely. I think everybody thought they were throwing the football. Caught him off guard.
Yeah, I'm telling you, when you have the courage to make that type of a play call, a lot of times you actually get rewarded.
First down. It's Craig. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. action here. It's a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And now they'll throw with Lance. Going up top. And it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up in that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he gets this one down to the 24. 52 yards rushing for him now on just six carries to this point. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Here's Lance. And he holds it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. Jerry Rice there to make the grab. And the 49ers have now taken the lead. Extra point by Anderson. Up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. Touchdown. Here's Anderson to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble to bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. A one-yard gain there following the three-yard pickup on first down. An extra DB for the 49ers now on third. They're going to look to throw. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jason Verrett, and his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
Gonna do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. First down, Lance. And it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. Jerry Rice. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Niners are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Anderson. Up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Touchdown. Here's Anderson to kick it away. This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Yeah, the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a two-score deficit. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jason Verrett, and into...